Low tide is often seen as a moment when the ocean reveals its hidden secrets, both spiritual and physical. Some cultures even believe that as the waters recede, they leave behind not just treasures, but also insights into the mysteries of life. And sometimes, these hidden secrets are more than just spiritual. In May 2011, a geological team member, Eugene Pramaki, made an incredible discovery during an extremely low tide in southeast Alaska. While walking along the beach, something caught his eye. At first, he thought it was a fish or maybe a branch, but when he brushed it with his boot, he realized it was something much more significant – a fossil. The fossil turned out to be a prehistoric marine reptile called a Thalattosaur. This rare find could be the most complete Thalattosaur fossil ever found in North America. The photos were sent for further investigation to marine expert Patrick Druckenmiller. After studying the photos and considering the age of the surrounding rocks, Druckenmiller was nearly certain that the fossil was indeed a Thalattosaur. Thalattosaurs lived around 220 million years ago during the Triassic period. They were marine reptiles that ranged from 3 to 10 feet long, with long tails and paddle-like limbs. The fossil was located in an intertidal zone, meaning it was only exposed during extremely low tides. Druckenmiller and his team had just a few hours each day to excavate the fossil before the tide rose again. After 2 days of careful work, the team successfully retrieved the fossil, encased in 500 pounds of rock. It was then shipped to a museum lab, where experts will slowly reveal the fossil over several months. This find is a major discovery and may help scientists learn more about the Thalattosaurs. Low tides often reveal hidden surprises, but sometimes they bring unexpected visitors to the shore. In 2022, after weeks of record rainfall in Australia, something strange happened. Brightly colored sea dragons started washing up on beaches in New South Wales, baffling experts and beachgoers alike. These unusual discoveries left everyone wondering what was going on beneath the waves. The sea dragons, known for their vibrant orange, yellow, and purple colors, are usually found in Australian waters but rarely stray far from home. They tend to stay within 20 to 50 meters of their kelp-covered patches for their entire lives. Yet, more than 20 of these stunning creatures were found on various beaches, including Cronulla, Malabar, and the Central Coast. What's even more surprising is their size. Some of these stranded sea dragons were 10 times larger than normal. This strange occurrence has led to various theories. Marine experts from the University of Technology Sydney argued that the recent record rainfall, pollutants washed into the ocean, and large surf might have played a role. The heavy rains and stormy weather likely disturbed their habitats, forcing them into the open waters, where they eventually washed ashore. Beachgoers were shocked to find these vibrant creatures during their walks. One visitor who found 7 sea dragons in a week described how vibrant and colorful they were, even after death. The discovery of these sea dragons highlights how changes in weather and environmental conditions can have surprising and sometimes alarming effects on marine life. Beachgoers in Oregon recently stumbled upon a rare and striking sight. A large, vibrant opah fish washed ashore on Sunset Beach, just north of Seaside. The opah, also known as a moonfish, measured an impressive 3.5 feet long and weighed about 100 pounds. This unusual discovery quickly caught the attention of the Seaside Aquarium, which responded promptly and preserved the fish in a freezer for future educational use. Opah fish are not your average sea creatures. These fish, typically found in warmer tropical waters, have a unique disc-like shape, making them look almost like a giant coin. Their appearance is nothing short of stunning, with bright red-orange fins and a metallic silver-blue body. Opah is usually found in deep ocean waters, far from the shore, making this particular find along the Oregon coast a rare event. The fish discovered on Sunset Beach isn't the first of its kind to appear in Oregon waters, but it's still a significant event. Back in 2009, a Milwaukee man caught a 97-pound opah while fishing for tuna near the mouth of the Columbia River. However, the sight of a 100-pound opah washing up on the beach is a much rarer occurrence, and it has sparked curiosity among locals and scientists alike. Opah fish can grow even larger than the one found on Sunset Beach. Some species can reach up to 6 feet in length and weigh as much as 600 pounds. Despite their size, they are known for their agility in the water, using their powerful pectoral fins to navigate the deep ocean. This particular opah is now a valuable specimen for educational purposes. The Seaside Aquarium plans to use it to teach visitors about this fascinating species, which is rarely seen up close. Shipwrecks often hide secrets beneath the waves, and low tides can reveal these hidden stories. When the tide goes out, parts of old ships sometimes emerge from the sand and mud, offering a glimpse into the past. One such shipwreck is the Crested Eagle, a British paddle steamer with a dramatic history. During World War II, the Crested Eagle played a crucial role in the Dunkirk evacuation. This was a major rescue operation to save Allied soldiers stranded on the beaches of Dunkirk, France. On May 29, 1940, the Crested Eagle was heavily damaged by German aircraft. The ship was hit and caught fire, struggling to stay afloat amidst the chaos. Despite its brave efforts to rescue stranded soldiers, the vessel eventually sank. The attack resulted in the loss of many lives and marked the ship as a symbol of wartime sacrifice and bravery. Today, the wreck of the Crested Eagle lies partially submerged off the coast of Dunkirk. As the tide goes out, the remains of the ship become visible. The exposed sections reveal parts of the wreck that are normally hidden beneath the water. Beachgoers and history enthusiasts can see these remnants when the tide is low, making it a unique opportunity to connect with the past. Speaking of shipwrecks, an extraordinary discovery emerged from the depths of Lake Erie. After a winter storm swept through the Great Lakes region, low water levels exposed a hidden shipwreck, still equipped with two cannons. The phenomenon, known as a sesh, caused the water level on the Toledo, Ohio side of the lake to drop by 12 feet, while the Buffalo, New York side remained high. This drastic change allowed people to glimpse the bottom of the lake, where the shipwreck lay hidden for centuries. Photos of the discovery took social media by storm. The sight of the wreck with its two cannons was both eerie and captivating. However, not everyone was convinced it was a ship. Researchers from the National Museum of the Great Lakes suggested it might be an old pier or dockage instead. But the mystery remains unsolved, as the waters quickly returned to normal, covering the site once again. Lake Erie holds many secrets, with researchers estimating that around 2,000 ships are buried beneath its waters. Yet, only a few hundred have been found, leaving much of its history still submerged. A video about discoveries made during low tide is incomplete without mentioning the River Thames. The Thames has a rich history hidden beneath its murky waters. Twice a day, as the tide recedes, the river reveals secrets that have been buried for centuries. This phenomenon has given rise to a practice known as mudlarking. Mudlarking is the act of searching the Thames' muddy shores for hidden treasures during a low tide. What began as a necessity for the poor in the 18th and 19th centuries has now become a popular hobby. Today, enthusiasts and archaeologists alike comb the riverbanks, hoping to find a piece of history. The finds range from everyday items to extraordinary relics. Roman coins, medieval pottery, and even Tudor shoes have been unearthed. Each object tells a story about the people who lived and worked along the Thames. One of the most remarkable discoveries was a Bronze Age human skull, believed to be over 3,000 years old. This skull provides a direct connection to London's ancient past, offering clues about the lives of the city's earliest inhabitants. Another important find was a Roman cup, which was thought to be 1,800 years old. Another fascinating find was a Roman brooch, intricately designed and remarkably well-preserved. More recently, a Victorian-era bottle, complete with its original contents, was found. It's a testament to how the river has preserved pieces of everyday life from centuries ago. So far, we've talked about how low tides can reveal hidden treasures like shipwrecks and fossils. But what if I told you that low tides can also change the way animals hunt? One fascinating example of this is the coastal wolves in Alaska. These wolves have adapted their hunting strategies to take advantage of low tide cycles. Scientists have recently observed them hunting marine mammals like sea otters and harbor seals. This behavior was first noted in 2016 when a solitary wolf was seen carrying a sea otter carcass along the Alaskan coast. At first, it wasn't clear if the wolves were hunting or scavenging. However, in 2021, researchers witnessed three wolves hunting and killing an adult sea otter during low tide. The fresh blood at the kill site confirmed the wolves had actively hunted their prey. This discovery highlights how these coastal wolves have learned to hunt alone or in small groups, which differs from their inland counterparts, who usually hunt in packs. Moreover, these coastal wolves can narrow down and hunt at sites where prey is most predictable, such as tidal streams or rocky islands. Researchers found that wolf predation coincided with low tide cycles, indicating they had developed an awareness of where and when the sea otters were spending time on land. That's all for today. Which discovery surprised you the most? Let us know in the comments below. We'll see you next time.